And it's the rains are down heavily right now in most parts of the metropolis. Some parts are still looking very, very dry. Here in Ikeja, it's been raining cats, dogs, giraffes, and elephants. Ojota, the same thing. Bagada, we're looking at the same thing, same situation. On Ikorodu Road, it's the same. Anthony, looking the same. K2 Ojota, it's been raining as well. Same goes for Oshodi. But I see that around Iyanowo, it's still cloudy. The rains are still gathering momentum there. Ojota is poured and it stopped. But I'm sure that we'll be getting more reports. All you know, within the metropolis, it still looks good at the moment. Closing time, so we have more vehicles on the road. People are still going about their businesses. And, well, we can continue to give you a situation report. Welcome to Save Blood Arena on Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM. And my name is Dele Agadumo. Save Blood Arena is brought to you courtesy Lagos State Blood Transfusion Services. And here we tell you everything you need to know about blood donation, voluntary blood donation, blood safety, blood security. And we've also talked about all of the guidelines that the WHO has outlined for blood services and how you can keep your blood secure. So you have absolutely nothing to worry about when it comes to blood donation, at least here in Lagos State. Yes, you have absolutely nothing to worry about. All right, so on the program today, I have the safety officer at LSBTS, Mrs. Taslima Davis for Lawrence Shaw. Good evening. Welcome to the program.
Good evening, Ma. Good evening, Lagosians. Thank you for having me.
All right. It's a pleasure. Welcome. And of course, I have Taiwo Oloko. He is the Quality Assurance Officer, LSBTS. Good evening again. Welcome.
Good evening.
All right. All right. So let me start by having my first set of conversation with the safety officer. What are some of the risks that the blood service personnel are exposed to while providing safe blood for Lagosians? I know that it cannot be an easy task. So what are some of those risks that you are exposed to, and what are the parameters set in place, safety parameters set in place to safeguard your profession and the blood given to Lagosians?
Thank you very much. Safety, it's all encompassing, mm-hmm. right from the donor's hand to the recipient who are the patients, mm-hmm. to the staff, and also to the blood product itself.
Okay.
So our donors, when they come to healthcare providers,
yes.
the risk we incur comes in three forms.
Okay.
It's either we incur it in physical form.
Okay.
In biologically or mm-hmm. in chemical.
Okay.
So physically, when we are, you know, there are some things that you you get in contact with, either taking a fall, you know, having exposure to needle prick.
Okay.
While collecting blood,
mm-hmm.
or when processing, there's a flash split back of blood and all that. So especially when you add any positive blood.
Okay.
Is that positive for any of the TTIs,
yes,
or any
yes.
of the infections that we can find in blood?
Mm-hmm.
Then chemical form, we make use of some chemicals,
okay.
during processes, that bleach, if you have a spillage of it, you can infect yourself, you can get yourself armed,
okay.
with such. And biologically, is all these pathogens. Is it that with viral diseases,
okay.
Ebola, coronavirus, HIV 1 and 2, mm-hmm. hepatitis B and C, and all yeah. that. So, health workers, day in, day out, we are liable to any of this risk,
yes.
While processing blood, yeah. or any of the blood body fluids, yeah. generally. Aside from any other thing, aside from blood too.
Yes.
So, and there are lots of measures that we can put in place, that has been in place to make sure we are protected mm-hmm. from this risk mm-hmm. by ensuring the use of PPE, okay. that's personal protective equipment,
yes.
our gloves, our lab coats, mm-hmm. our eye goggle, a face shield, your covered shoes, like a kind of yes. Crocs and
okay.
all that.
Okay.
So just to protect you, you don't go to the lab or to the blood
without
bank
properly
using
kitted.
Without being properly kitted. So, and when they are imaging diseases, mm-hmm. then we get kitted more.
Okay.
We hype the way we get ourselves kitted, so that we'll be protected. Mm-hmm. We go through training and retraining on how to use all these kits, also on fire hazards,
okay.
In case of fire hazard, we'll get drilling about that.
Okay.
On hand wash, as we see it, that is just wash hand.
No,
it goes beyond that.
Okay.
Once you are working as an healthcare provider, so there is a training to tell us when to start, where to start from, how you wash your hands, where to end it, and all that. Then also, how to take care of spills. When you have spills in the lab, how do you cater for it? So we keep training, getting training and retraining on all these ways of getting ourselves protected. And what to do when there are emergencies, when there are natural disasters, what do you do?
Okay.
When there is emergency preparedness, and what are your response to it, and all that. So from time to time, we get updated in line with what is obtainable in other clients.
Okay. When you were talking about some of those infections that you could be exposed to, I remember what happened with the advent of Ebola here in Nigeria. Where lots of health workers, doctors were infected. I remember that of coronavirus as well. So it's a high risk job.
Definitely.
It's a high risk job. And so it means that the level of preparedness and the level of protection has to be really, really high. And as you said, that anytime there's an emerging infection or a pandemic or something, there has to be an increase. Level of
protection. Up.
Okay. So, but before we go on, what's the insurance protection like for healthcare workers? Maybe I'll talk about your area, because it can't be easy. Every day when you're trying to bleed a person for donation, you have to be very, very careful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So nothing must pierce your gloves or, you know, for instance, if you have a donor that is shaky, you know, and while you're trying to bleed the person and there's a spill, so that means that you must be protected for you to make sure that nothing happens between the donor and you who is bleeding the person.
Definitely.
So is there any kind of insurance to help safeguard to help protect you as a healthcare worker?
When your donor is in for bleeding, mm-hmm. the donor will have been cancelled.
Okay.
And you are sure the donor of everything you are going to use for him or her are sterile.
Mm-hmm.
So she needs to be calm or he needs to be calm.
Mm-hmm.
And while on bed, you engage him or her by, you know, talking to him or her.
Okay.
So then you make sure he is stable. You want to bleed as well. The mm-hmm. phlebotomy has to be in a stable state of mind.
Okay.
To be focused.
Okay.
I need to be focused. I need to get this done. And I don't have to get myself infected.
Mm-hmm.
Nor do I have to get my donor also harmed anyway. So it's just a state of mind, a state of mind, actually.
Okay.
And insurance, as it is, that should be from the hand of the government anyway,
mm-hmm.
that making sure the life of every health worker is insured in any of the insurance companies.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's now open to them to know every health worker's health is very paramount. We need to get it insured in a way so that if there is any of this peradventure, then we know we are covered to some extent.
So maybe we'll start an advocacy push for that. All right, so now let's talk about, just walk us through some of those safety measures we've talked about during the production of Safe Blood for Lagosians or for anyone who would need it. What are those safety measures that are put in place to assure the recipient of the safe blood they are getting?
It all starts from our work environment. Mm-hmm. Our work environment has to be clean, mm-hmm. has to be, you know, sterile to mm-hmm. some extent, mm-hmm. and down to donor section,
okay.
where donor will be, you know, led at the end of the day. The donor will be given questionnaires to answer some questions, let us okay. know about your social life,
okay.
so that we'll be so sure we are dealing with the right set of people
right.
that WHO has, you know, seen as the right set of people to give us safe blood.
Okay.
So from that questionnaire, we'll be able to infer one or two things.
Mm.
Then some screening will be done on the donor. Himself,
mm-hmm.
Blood level will be checked, temperature, the BP, the weight of the donor, and all okay. that. After that, the blood will go down to the blood bank section where okay. blood group will be done, and everything in an enclosed system so that there would not be
okay.
interference of, you know, external substances that can have or pathogens that can have mm-hmm. effect on the blood you want to, you know, transfuse. Then to the screening room where TTIs will be done on the on the blood that has been collected
mm-hmm.
to be screened for HIV 1 and 2, hepatitis B and C, and syphilis. So like that, the process goes on. And during storage, we ensure each blood component is stored accordingly. If it's all blood or packed cell, it will be stored in a blood bank fridge at
okay.
2 to 6 degrees centigrade. If it's fresh frozen plasma, cryoprecipitate, those ones will be frozen
okay.
for at minus 70-80 degrees centigrade. And if it's platelets, it will be stored at room temperature.
Okay.
You know, that's 20-24 degrees centigrade for 5 to 7 days.
All right.
So this process is, it's all about the way the donor has been bled, what has okay. been done in the blood bank,
okay.
screening room, and at the end of the day, to the recipient, who is the patient.
Yes.
So while giving it out to the patient, we ensure the name on the blood given out, that's the patient's name, tallies with the form that is coming to the blood
okay.
bank.
Okay.
And we do blood group on it to be so sure of the group to give to the recipient.
The recipient.
Then compatibility testing
okay.
will be done. That's rule out results, ABO results incompatibility.
Okay.
We in Lagos State Blood Transfusion Service, we go to the extent of doing extended phenotyping to see if there are that group of antibodies that we need okay. to rule out in the patient.
Oh, all
right. That's Kell, Duffy, MNS, and the like.
Okay.
So during transportation, blood has been stored appropriately during transportation to the wards
mm-hmm.
or to the facilities that the recipient is. We ensure it's being transported
in the right temperature, also.
At the right temperature as
okay.
well,
wow.
in an insulated bag
okay.
with ice pack. So
okay.
all this will do from the point of collection to the point of transfusion. That is, we ensure there is a sterility from vein to vein,
okay.
from donor's end to the recipient
okay.
eventually.
Awesome. So we talked about safety trainings earlier. So what are some of those safety trainings that you've had to sit through to make sure that at every point in time, the highest safety guidelines are firmly adhered to?
Safety training, fire drill.
Okay.
Then appropriate hand hygiene.
Okay.
So we have been trained on how to do that. So other safety training
mm-hmm.
Will definitely follow suit.
Mm-hmm.
We have it planned. and we'll definitely get it executed.
Okay, so I'm curious, when you talked about proper hand washing techniques, okay, so is it possible for you to walk us through what a proper hand washing technique is?
When you want to wash your hands, you ensure you have your soap available,
okay.
You have running tap water available, then your soap on your palm, you rub your palm this way,
okay.
Not just washing it the normal way we wash at home.
Okay.
So you wash using your fingers, your right hand, using your right hand to you know, scrub through the surface of your palm.
Your palm, okay.
Then in between your fingers too.
Okay.
You scrub through.
Okay.
So you use one hand to assist the other in washing, just like you about to say, owo toma fowo simo and all that. So you do it that way, over and over. Then you rinse. While rinsing, you ensure you are not splashing water.
Okay.
And when you are done, you are not splashing or rubbing it on your clothes. Is that you use hand dryer to dry it, or you get a towel or toilet roll to just do wiping.
Okay.
Toilet roll is better than towel.
Than
anyway,
towel.
We eradicated the use of toilet roll. I mean,
and the towels.
Towels.
Okay.
Because you come.
What if the towels are steamed?
Steamed.
Yes. What if you're in that environment where you are privileged, so to speak, to have steamed towels?
Then that would be fine.
To wipe your hands.
Then it will be fine.
Awesome.
It will be fine.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Let me have this next chat with Taiwo. So what measures are in place to ensure that all of the blood collected in Lagos State meets safety standards? We spoke a bit about that, I think. But so for the benefit of those who did not listen to that edition, so let's have some of those measures that are put in place to ensure that blood collected in Lagos State meets safety standards.
Okay, thank you very much. Before I go to that, I just want to say something about the insurance stuff.
Oh, yes.
You know, we know that there's a Lagos State Health Management Agency,
yes.
And that's like the insurance.
Okay.
So I believe
that's
health workers in Lagos, and even all Lagos citizens are, you know, encouraged to. You know, so that's part of the insurance. So, and then also the government has improved on the hazard allowance that healthcare professionals get.
Okay.
So that's also part of it. So all these things help us in, you know, working on the safety level that of the safety level of our services.
Okay.
So to your main question, we do a lot of things to ensure that the safety standard of the blood that we give is high.
Okay.
The first thing that we do is to ensure that we get blood from the safest source.
All right.
Like they say in IT, garbage in,
garbage out.
Mm-hmm. So you have to get blood from the right source, and the right source or the safest source for blood is voluntary blood
and
voluntary blood donors.
Not paid.
Not remunerated. They're not doing it for anything. They're not doing it for cash. It's not about the money.
Okay.
It's about saving lives, about helping society, about giving back to society.
Okay.
So that's the first thing, and that's the most important thing, really. Then secondly, let me branch off to, not really branch off, let me just take a cue from the safety we are talking about.
Okay.
You cannot have safe blood if the environment is not safe.
True.
If you've not put safety measures that she's mentioned.
True.
Into place,
sure.
Then you can't have safe blood.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna have a lot of things go wrong, and then the blood will not be safe at the end of the day. But in Lagos City Blood Transfusion Service, we put every safety measure in place to ensure that even though we're getting blood from the safest source of blood, that safety
is maintained
until the final recipient collects the blood.
Okay.
So that's also key. So that keys into the main topic for today, which is the safety.
Yes.
So apart from that, we also screen the blood. She mentioned it.
Yes.
We don't use any form of screening. We use the best form of screening that is available
to us. She said WHO approved.
Exactly.
Yes.
WHO approved screening methods are used. Mm-hmm. And we screen not for one, not for two, but for four transfusion transmissible infections, TTIs. So we screen for HIV 1 and 2, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and syphilis. Mm-hmm. All these are done to ensure the safety of the blood at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. And we go way beyond that. Okay. After screening it and making sure that, okay, it's okay, it's fit for human consumption, it can be transfused mm-hmm. safely. We also label it. We don't just assume that anybody that picks it up is going to know that it's safe.
Okay.
It's labeled that the ones that have been found to have issues are discarded.
Discarded. Okay.
And it's normal that does the discarding for us. We don't just put it in the environment. No, it's discarded properly.
All right.
To ensure that whatever that is not wholesome is not introduced into society is mm-hmm. destroyed appropriately. Mm-hmm. You know, so the safety stickers, the stickers on the blood ensures that everybody that is collected, and that's why I keep saying anytime I come here, if you're getting blood, ask for the sticker.
Okay.
Check the sticker on the blood, on the unit of the pint of blood that you're receiving or your relative is going to get.
Mm.
It's not just, I don't buy blood. Let me just use it. No.
Okay.
There has to be a Lagos State sticker that shows the blood is safe for transfusion.
Okay.
It's after you see that, you know, you can transfuse. So those are some of the measures and the key, very important measures that we take to ensure that it's only safe blood that is made available for Lagosians to use.
Okay, fantastic. Awesome. Thank you so, so, so much. All right, so for those of you who are just tuning in, we have been speaking with Mrs. Taslima Davis Folorosho, Safety Officer with Lagos State Blood Transfusion Services, and also our regular Sataiwo Oloko Quality Assurance Officer, also with the LSBTS. And we have been discussing safety in the blood service. So you have heard them talk about the risks that the healthcare workers are exposed to, especially when they are bleeding during blood donation and during screening and stuff. She has enumerated some of those risks. She's also talked about the safety measures put in place by the LSBTS and the Lagos State Government during the production of safe blood. We've also highlighted some of the safety trainings that they have been exposed to, required for them to continue to serve you better. And we've talked about the measures that are put in place to ensure that all blood collected in Lagos State meet safety standards. So in closing today, let's quickly talk just in a minute or half a minute. Let's quickly talk a bit about the benefits that voluntary blood donors stand to gain if they come forward to donate. Voluntary blood donors.
Okay, thank you. Let me even add one of the other safety measures, you know, that we take to ensure that blood is safe.
Okay.
All units of blood are quality controlled and quality assured.
Okay.
So we do quality checks mm-hmm. on all batches of blood.
Okay.
That we, you know, issue out to the different blood banks and the individuals that need them. So that's also a safety measure, because to provide full safety, safety is an holistic thing.
Yes.
So you also have quality control and assure mm-hmm. all the things that you do to ensure that, you know, wherever there are any quality issues, they're addressed and they're not, you know, repeated and avoided in the future.
Yes.
So for voluntary donors, they benefit a lot.
Mm-hmm.
The first thing is that feeling of achievement, that feeling of contributing to society, of saving lives.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing better than that. There's no financial benefit that surpasses that. You know, it's just like what they say about people working, and people think they work for money. Most people, it's not about the money.
Yeah.
It's about value that you add to society.
Yes.
So donating blood is the highest level of value that you can add to society
mm-hmm.
because you're literally saving lives. Mm. From last week's discussion with Timmy,
Okay.
Timmy.
Oh yeah, Timmy Edwin.
Timmy Edwin. Yeah. Yes. She said it.
Mm-hmm.
She's a sickle cell warrior,
mm-hmm.
and she mentioned it that literally blood donors are literally saving the lives of mm-hmm. people that require blood regularly and those that need it at any time.
Yeah.
So there's no value more than that.
Okay.
Other benefits that can come with it is you have access to blood when you or a member of your family need blood,
mm-hmm.
and you go with your donor card.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to get assaulted. You're just going to get the blood because we recognize the value that you're put into society, that you're giving to society.
All right.
And we want to pay you back in that little way.
Okay.
By making sure that whenever you or any member of your immediate family needs blood,
it's
they
being
get
available
it,
without
you
stress.
Know, in a seamless, you okay. know, process.
Okay.
So those are two benefits that I can say for now.
Awesome. Awesome. All right. Thank you very, very much, both of you, for being on the program today. Thank you so, so much. All right. So again, Save Blood Arena is brought to you courtesy Lagos State Blood Transfusion Services. And you can get in touch via Facebook, Lagos Blood Transfusion. On Instagram, it's Lagos State Blood Transfusion. On X, formerly Twitter, is Lagos BTS. And the telephone number is 0806-920-7914. Again, 0806-920-7914. Thank you so much, everybody, for listening. You can watch back episodes of the program via our Twitter handle, Traffic Radio 961, to catch up. And if you have any other questions, all of the social media handles have been made available to you where you can get in touch with the LSBTS and ask as many questions as you want. My name is Dele Agadumo. Enjoy the rest of your day. And big thanks goes to Victor Terry and executive producer Tayo Akonle.